The Norwich University softball team is coming off a 2012 campaign that saw them win 21 games and earn a trip to the GNAC playoffs. And with no losses to graduation and a strong nucleus returning with more experience under their belt, the Cadets are ready to go in 2013.
Yeah, very confident. We're a very young team. We lost two players who decided not to return. One is not at Norwich and one decided not to play. But we didn't graduate anyone. Our key performers, our key role players, and our team leaders all returned.
The Cadets will look to a balanced attack this year, being led on the mound by sophomore Corinne Beta and junior Kaylee Miller. But they also bring back senior slugger Noel Byers and all GNAC selections Kelly Travers and Brianna Day.
I think we're pretty deep defensively. We have a number of players that can play different positions and rotate around, so we're really strong there. And also our batting, our lineup, I think we're going to have a really strong lineup. Like I said, we didn't graduate any seniors last year, so we had a fairly decently a strong lineup last year. So I think this year we're able to just join the freshmen into that lineup and make it even stronger.
To be quite honest, we're a fairly balanced attack now. We're our greatest change, our greatest improvement this year, or the biggest difference you'll see, is the depth that we have. With the five freshmen we added significant depth, especially with our outfield.
Norwich was tabbed 7th in the GNAC preseason coaches poll, and McGrath is using that ranking as motivation for his group. The Cadets open play Sunday in Myrtle Beach against Mitchell.
The preseason poll came out, the coaches poll. I was pleased and I was frustrated, and I presented it to our young women that way, to our players that way. Pleased because there's a level of respect. I think we finished 7th, but then the number 18 was significantly lower in terms of point totals. So there's sort of we're right smack in the middle of the pack, but we're in the upper pack, upper half of the pack, votes wise. It's very clearly that there is an upper tier and a lower tier in the conference, at least what the coaches are seeing and voting on. So that brought some confidence. That was positive. The frustration, the disappointment is that although we finished 5th last year and we played very well, surprised some folks, impressed some folks, and beat some of those top-tier teams, including St. Joe's, Maine, and Simmons last year. In spite of that, we are still down number 7, and we'd like to prove to them and are confident that we can prove to them that we're going to finish better than 7th.